Who doesn't love a bit of stained glass? Up here on my perch in the roof, I get to watch how the sunlight captures the colours of the images and casts them about the dusty walls and floors. It's like being inside a constantly moving work of art. Westminster Abbey is itself a work of art, built for the glory of God. And look at me, just a lonesome corbel, an old stone head stuck up in the rafters. I know I'm no oil painting, but I wouldn't say I have an unattractive mug. Much of what people see when they come to visit us at the Abbey is the result of Henry III spending huge sums of money in order to build a beautiful church. His inspiration was Saint Edward the Confessor. Henry wanted to rebuild Edward's Abbey and make it bigger and better, all for his love of the saint. And once the building was finished, what better way to glorify God and the saint but to fill it with expensive treasures and beautiful works of art? Well, these stained glass windows tell stories from the Bible or of the saints, George and the Dragon, Edward the Confessor and the Ring. And there's even an image of Henry III holding up a model of his brand new abbey. Cheeky so-and-so. Then there's the shrine of Edward the Confessor, where he's buried. This was covered in semi-precious stones and glittering gold. It was quite a sight to see, and pilgrims would travel from hundreds of miles to pray there. Some of these pilgrims love the saints so much, I even noticed one or two of them prizing a few of those precious stones from the side of the shrine when they should have been praying. Can you imagine? Some of the art in the abbey isn't quite so glittery and easy to spot. There are a couple of wall paintings, one of St. Thomas and the other of St. Christopher. They're big and beautiful and about 700 years old, and you'd think that something as important as these paintings would be on display for all to see, but the truth is that we lost them. No one knew where they were until in 1934 some cleaners, poking around the back of a couple of monuments, discovered these amazing works of art. It took a couple of years before they were able to get those big stone monuments out of the way and reveal the true beauty of these paintings. But back to the stained glass. There's one more image I want you to see. It's a window that was installed very recently. A vibrant work of art by someone called David Hockney. They call it the Queen's Window, and it was made to celebrate the reign of Queen Elizabeth II. Now, I know what you're thinking. This looks nothing like the stained glass windows I'm used to seeing. You're right. I certainly have never seen anything else like it in the Abbey, but I think that may well be its point. It's brave and daring and stands out alone amongst the stone monuments and memorials. It's another sign, perhaps, of how this great stone building is ever changing. Who knows what kinds of artwork I might get to see over the next few hundred years. Perhaps there might even be something made by you.